is Jackie Garrett. Jackie is a citizen of Roane County, West Virginia. He is concerned about his future and the future of the county. Jackie just recently contributed $1 toward the building of a new hospital for Roane County. Like Jackie, the citizens of Roane County are concerned about their future and are ready to rise up and meet the demands of a county on the move. Roane County was formed in 1856 from parts of Kanawha, Jackson, and Gilmer, and named in honor of Judge Spencer Roane, distinguished Virginia jurist, whose wife, Anne, was the daughter of Patrick Henry. The population is around 16,000. Primarily an agricultural and grazing region, its economy is also affected by oil and gas production. Spencer, the county seat, with a population of over 3,000, is a thriving community, a trading center for the county's agricultural and area population. The Spencer State Hospital for Treatment of Mental Patients is the second oldest such institution established in West Virginia. In Roane County, the first Black Walnut Festival was held. This activity has grown steadily since that time, until crowds of up to 20,000 annually attend this festival. The diversified industry is the badge of this territory. Prior to 1940, the science of cattle raising and the development of agriculture, motivated by the richness of its soil and its rolling pasture lands, dominated the economy. Roane County is indeed a very fortunate area. Mother Nature endowed it with enormous natural resources, and its people, through the decades, have possessed sufficient ambition and imagination to avail themselves of the opportunities which nature gave them. Slowly, the number of farms began to decline, and the labor began a gentle drift toward absorption by local industry. For over 30 years, there was a significant trend toward a higher percentage of people moving to urban areas. Many of the small farms are being abandoned as farm operators find it is no longer possible to make a living by his existing methods of farming. Roane County is generally a pretty rough county. Land is fertile, and the ridge land is mostly rolling. The land between the ridges and bottom is generally steep, and where pastured, is severely eroded. The steep land had to be kept cleared by hand methods where it was used for pastures. New processes in the production of oil and gas, long important in the economy of the people of Roane County, has recently brought new life in this area of industry. These riches of nature sleep here in abundance, and man is now inventing new methods for their recovery. The community's population swelled with the addition of factories. Spencer Manufacturing Company, a producer of sweaters, supplies a national market. It employs 500 people and has plans in the future for expansion. Spencer National Guardsmen have a proud record. The new armory, built in 1961, has extra banquet facilities to accommodate 500 persons, for which addition the city of Spencer and Roane County pledged to pay the additional cost. Further efforts, a new courthouse was built, a most imposing building. The people of this region have always met their needs with a strong will and lots of determination. That determination built this park and will most likely build others. In 1938, 10 miles from Spencer, land was purchased by the court for a permanent 4-H camp and recreational area. The recreational area includes a baseball and football field, complete with lights and dugouts. Picnic facilities, including outside tables, are also available. This is the Methodist Youth Camp. Natural landscaping, plus mirror lakes and rolling meadows, add charm to this natural beauty spot. Plans are for this conference center to accommodate 200 people upon its completion. This volunteer fire department serves all of Roane County. Day or night, these volunteers are on their toes with the latest trucks and modern equipment. These are people on the move, people who care. But where there are people, progress, and prosperity, there are also problems. In the United States of America, there is one MD for every 750 persons. In West Virginia, there is one MD for every 1,030 persons. In Roane County, there is one MD for every 3,150 persons. This, then, was the problem. Roane County needed more doctors, better medical facilities. Doctors coming out of medical school want to work in modern surroundings with the latest medical devices. The answer? A new, modern, efficient hospital in Roane County. The small private hospital there could not possibly keep up with the expanding community. And driving to the nearest hospitals in Charleston and Parkersburg, and even Clarksburg, is a frightening experience. They're just too far away. This was a serious challenge to all the community-minded citizens. A crisis, yes. But Roane County could do it. They did before. A possible site was chosen. One easily accessible to all of Roane County. One overlooking the beautiful countryside. Could they do it? This was a big challenge.
been with you some weeks now, and I have traced this general campaign and the advance gift committee before it. And it has been, first, dedication. It's been hard work, and it's been keeping steadfastly to the job until the task was finished.
$45,035.
$45,035.
Composite total for Division J.
$12,320.
For our hospital development company campaign, as of this moment, stands at $514,465.32.
So the demands were met, and even more. The proposed hospital that was in the planning stage only a few months was achieved. The people of this mighty and determined region had come through again. How this was done and how they felt can best be told by the people of the community.
Mr. Griggs, could you tell me what do you feel in regard to the tremendous success of the hospital drive and what it will do for the people of this county?
Well, Dave, I feel this is one of the greatest achievements that Roane County has ever had. The community spirit has been great all through the campaign. I think we've done a wonderful job.
I'm delighted, of course. If you had asked me 3 months ago whether this could have been done in this community, I would have said no. I'm amazed and delighted, and I think it's the finest thing that's ever happened, certainly in Roane County since I've lived here.
Certainly, I'm extremely proud to have been a citizen of this community, and I feel that it just bears out the fact that we are progressive thinking people here and have an eye for the future.
Now, McCarthy, I wondered if you could tell me, as mayor of this town, what you feel that this hospital drive and the future that this hospital will bring to this area, could you give me your comments on what you feel as a citizen of Roane County?
Well, first of all, Mr. Batchelor, let me say that I feel that this is probably the crowning achievement that the citizens of Roane County have put together in the 100-odd year history of this county. As for the hospital itself, we all know that it will greatly enhance not only our medical services to people, but our facilities, our means of treating the sick. It's a definite need here, and we're certainly very proud of the job that has been done here by the citizenry, and I speak on behalf of the citizens of Spencer. This is a fine thing. We're very happy with it.
Could I ask you now, as mayor of this town, you state that you're very, very proud of the people for the achievements of the campaign. Could you tell me, what will this do to the economy of this area by having this hospital here?
Well, of course, Mr. Batchelor, we have no way of knowing in advance, but most of us who have discussed this in the meetings, the various meetings that have been had, feel that it will make a significant achievement toward attracting a higher type of person, toward attracting industry, toward attracting fine people to our area, which will certainly not hurt the business community's chances at any rate.
Thank you very much, Mayor McCarthy. Mrs. Drake, I wondered if you could tell me, as the person responsible for the women's division of this campaign for a new hospital in Spencer and in Roane County, could you tell me what your reactions are and what you feel it has done to this community on the tremendous success of the whole, complete campaign.
I think the greatest thing that's happened is the community, again, has worked together. There has never, in the years that I've been in Roane County, been anything that so many people have worked so diligently toward. And I think today, most people are feeling very excited about what has just happened in their community.
Well, tell me, Mr. Drake, when you were selected to work as the woman's chairman, what were your feelings at the very beginning?
I think at the beginning, I didn't know really what we were about to do. And as I became more acquainted with what was really happening, I began to think how serious a job we were working toward. And never have I worked with a group of women that really worked without having too many comments or too many things said to them to get the job done. They just went out and worked. They wanted to do the job.
Do you feel that now that this campaign has proved successful, that in future, when any other campaign where there is a need in Roane County, do you feel that the people of this area will unite once again and help the way they have done in this campaign?
I'm sure that if it's a campaign for something the people of Roane County want, it'll be a successful campaign the next time, just like it was this time. No matter what it will be for, they'll do it.
It's one project that we've had in Roane County that all people, all the citizens, have got fully behind and pushed. I think it's been a fun drive and a good success.
I think it is one of the most worthy causes that the people of Roane County have gone together to help put over. I think it's something we desperately needed.
Mr. Haney, I believe you were the campaign director of this fundraising drive for the new hospital. I wondered if you could tell us, what is your feeling in regards to the success of this drive?
Well, they're very deep emotions and mixtures. This is a magnificent illustration of what a people in a community can do by uniting and working together for a common cause. Now, no matter how skilled a director and his staff may be, without the backing of the community and the people working, we can have no success. We were successful here because of these people, because of their awareness of a very severe problem, the problem of hospital and medical care. Many times through the night and early hours of the morning, these people and their relatives have gone to distant places, to Charleston, to Parkersburg, to even Clarksburg, in cases of emergency. Now then, when we started this campaign about 2 months ago, people were so thrilled with the idea that now, for the first time, we would have a non-profit hospital that would serve all. So they all pulled together, they organized, they worked, they received instructions, and finally succeeded. It is a magnificent example of what cooperation and pulling together will do. Backed by this was the history of an idea. A germ was born when the leaders felt the time has come when no longer we can do without adequate facilities. Meetings were held, this idea was born, and then we were brought into the picture, and we gave our know-how, we gave of our spirit, but we could do nothing without them, the people. And I am grateful, as are all of us, that we were able to work together and produce what we have produced, because it is for the people and it will serve them for many years to come.
A community-owned hospital located here will eliminate travel expenses to existing hospitals in surrounding communities. It will also provide employment for citizens, skilled or semi-skilled, in the medical profession, and will make it easier for friends and relatives to visit patients. Perhaps the greatest single feature of the new hospital will be the refreshing opportunity to plan, organize, and serve in terms of needs rather than limitations. Yes, the future looks bright for Jackie and all the citizens of Roane County, because the people there are looking ahead, ready to meet their next challenge or next crisis, because it's a county on the move.